They're not real. They're not good.
What?
I mean, they're good.
And real gold, but just not.
Have you seen him up?
Off the corner.
I'm not sure.
Yeah, yeah. I'm just taking on the street, right? I'm trying to get a little bit of fun, right? Do you have balls, Ben?
Yeah, no. Like
ball back.
Who has it?
Oh, Ben's late. Come later with him.
Yeah.
Okay. No team manager.
Really?
Where are they?
Ben Hales is going to be late.
The Ben Amir, who's our team manager? Rob.
Yeah.
He's away, is he?
Yeah, I think he's on injured.
Is Fergus still away?
Yeah.
All right, guys. So the reason I asked is that I sent out an email to coaches and team managers last night. A couple of days ago, just to sort out training sessions for the rest of the year until November, so we can spread out and use all the venues that we can, so we can keep the bookings for next year. So, when school starts back next week, it'll be the Div 2s and 3s here, and Div 1s will be at Ivanhoe with the Prem 2 team on Tuesday. So Monday will be will be Div 2s and 3s, and Tuesday at Ivanhoe will be Prem 2 and the Reserve 1. Okay, so, and the Thursday will be open to the Reserves 1 and Prem 2 who train on Tuesday, so they can train on Thursday, and you guys will train at Div 2 and Div 3 will train at Ivanhoe on a Wednesday. Okay, so not a lot has changed in terms of Div 2s and 3s. A slight difference for the Div 1.
Where's the Thursday?
The Thursday is at Maribyrnong, essentially for those, for the Prem players in Res 1 that I don't want them to train on a Tuesday, Wednesday. Because normally all Res teams would be training Monday, Wednesday.
Yep.
But now I've had to split them up, so Res Prem 2 and Res 1 train on Tuesday, and they'll be training on Thursday out at Maribyrnong. Okay? This is just purely to allow us to keep venues. Okay, if this is not going to work, I'm going to cancel venues, and whatever we get, you get next year, and so be it. That's what the situation is. If we're able to get those players involved in training on those nights. So Andre and myself will be here most Mondays. I'll be here probably every second Monday. And Steve will be training you guys on the Wednesdays. Okay? So I want to train as a group. And when we get here, let's all warm up as a group. I don't want, like it happened tonight, that's fine, you weren't aware. But I want to gel. I want to get the players together and work together to improve for next year, okay? This is the time where we work on skills. Yep. We don't have issues about training for games and that sort of shit that goes on during the season. We focus on team structure and system play and that sort of stuff. This is a great opportunity now to work on skills, and that's what we're going to do for the next hour and a bit. When it opens up at 8:30, we can probably take one call, but I've got to sort out some equipment issues over on that side with new volleyball poles and stuff like that that Melbourne Mini have bought, and now Mets don't fit them. So I'm going to try and work that out and sort that problem out. But in the meantime, so what I want you to do. If you want to grab a quick drink after my chat, I don't know, I probably need one, but grab a quick drink and then come back. Okay, guys? Quickly. what's more important in terms of setting, you know, just setting to ourselves there is great, but let's get to purpose, and I always want to have the corner-to-corner purpose. So if we can, how many have you got? Who's a quick counter? Quick. You've got Jonathan. If you can see everyone, that's why.
29. I'm like 33.
Yeah. Thank you. two ends for not good things. More lazy things that I see than we should be doing. Okay, so it's one thing to get from to follow the ball from there or from here to there or there to here, but you've got to get there quickly, and then particularly if you're from the middle seat to the outside, to get to here and after you've got here, what do you need to do? Be your next nut. What do you think you need to do? Do you understand the question or not? So, you've just said where Tam is. Tam's just said he's run here. He's getting. What is he going to do? He's going to get ready for the next touch. Yeah? That's where I see the laziness approach. Yeah. So instead of running and getting ready and waiting for the guy to move and then I'm ready here, yeah, we're standing. We're standing and we're digging this way. Yeah. You don't do that in the game. So you've got to get down and get ready. Doesn't matter whether the ball lasts long or short. When we're digging or when we see, we're still in preparation mode. Yeah? And I don't see that. So we have to improve on that. Doesn't matter how basic the drill is. Yeah, if you're not prepared, you'll always be late. And you'll always execute the skill incorrectly. Okay, so preparedness is essential in every part of the skill that you do. So that's one thing. The other thing I see, and that's technique, is I see a lot of people drawing their six gun. Coming out here and drawing and receiving like this. Yep. How do you think I want to see it, guys? The guys who know me, how do I teach? No? Sharp?
Me? Up and up.
Yep.
Ready?
Ready. Yep. So I'm bringing my arms together from here, not from here, yep, and straightening them. Because what I'm doing is I'm waiting for the ball, and if I have to go back here and then out, I'm going to be late. But if I'm here and bring my arm across, yeah, if I'm here straight and I bring my arm across, I'm already digging. Right? So if I'm here like this, digging, yeah, or here like that, digging, I'm not coming in here, digging this way, and then back here, digging that way. Okay? Because if the ball doesn't come to you down here, you're going to come up and set. Right? But you've got to prepare your arms nice and straight. Nice and straight. Okay? So I think we had two groups of six and one group of five, something like that. No, two groups of six and the others of five. So this time what I want to see is just really working on
thank you.
to the ball. Yep. So you're still here, correct? Yep. Then you're pinning. Too late. Okay. You want a long leader. A long leader makes it easy to move the ball around. Here, short. Yep. Very hard to target, to direct the ball when you've got your arms locked under your chest. Yep. Long leader. Long. Okay. How many more have we got to do with these? The skill is not only on we see on digging the ball as a guy that's working, but the skill is also on the guys that are throwing. Now, if you make it impossible, they can't achieve it. If you make it challenging, they have to work a little bit harder when they get there. So make it challenging, not impossible. Throw down the line so he can work sidesteps. Yeah? Cross shuffle. Okay? Don't do it low because he'll never get there. Yeah? Make it challenging, not impossible. Let's go. Finish up on your last one.
Thank you.
done it wrong, Greg.
Oh, we've already got one.
All right, guys, come here. Up.
Thank you.
Thank you. 3 minutes, get it over.
I won.
They call that the
red. Yeah.
Yeah. That's why I'm hitting it at you.
Just someone demonstrate very quick, just a good sets.
here, when do you want to start your run? Because most of the people are right here, right? 50 at the present day?
Different.
Alright, let's go over there.
Oh, never mind. I'm Jason. Yes.
Thank you.
attacking position. Okay. You start with the hands of the just to the back. And then you can do the position for his back. Get to
in the fuck? Bro, every time I touch the ball, I'm having a panic attack, bro. I forgot how to set.
Every time I double-double. Oh,
there's two things that we need to get clear. I mean, it's nice, it's fine to do that during one, but like, it's okay to share. The first one is like, when you guys are in, like, I think a few of you are like, starting somewhere here. Like, let's try to be a bit like gay. Why is okay? You're probably not going to have the time to jump on that.
Thank you. Send it.